Well, David, I reckon you have already taken care of business with our external cargo surveyors.
Yes, Peter. They've finished calculating our cargo and are now ready to do the same at the Rio.
Great. Let's get them over first so I can be in attendance throughout the transfer operation and fulfill my role as the person in overall charge. Should we use the gangway or the personnel basket? What do you think, Nick?
Both crane, basket and crew are certified for this kind of operation, and we have a risk assessment based on evaluation of weather, sea state and any other relevant factors. And we have the all-important life jackets right here.
This is absolutely the safest and quickest way. A workboat transfer is a good alternative, but it's much slower. Nick and I will take the next trip with the personnel basket.
While they accomplish the first transport mission, we should put on the life jackets and required safety equipment.
Welcome on board the Rio. Please let me introduce you to my Chief Officer, Charles Brown.
Thanks, Michael. And this is Chief Officer of the Mary, David Long. And my aspiring Superintendent, Nick Carter.
Nice to meet you. Well, everything has run smoothly so far, but before we continue with the cargo transfer, we have to conduct this meeting in order to meet the safety regulations. As you are the person in overall control of the operation, I suggest that you lead this meeting, Peter.
No problem, Michael. It's also my responsibility to ensure that the cargo transfer operation is carried out in accordance with the requirements of the receiving ship. However, Nick here is assisting me today. I hope that you are okay with him conducting this meeting. Great. Well, Nick, where do you suggest we start? And what point should we cover? Yes, there should always be one person at the manifold. Two persons checking moorings, fenders, anchor, and carry out security surveillance rounds. The duty officer or chief officer should be the navigational and anchor watch. The engine should always be manned by one engineer and motorman. What do you think, Charles?
Yes, it looks good. This is our watch plan.
When you take the anchor watch, as the STCW regulation prescribes, it won't be necessary to have one on the Mary as well, but otherwise the watch plan on the Mary will be similar to yours. Next issue is emergency procedures. Do you have any questions on the emergency signals and shutdown procedures?
No, the crew is familiar with the procedures and know what first action to be taken. Any leakage or other problem will be immediately reported to the officer in charge.
Okay, it seems the security arrangements are in place. Regarding the transfer, we have agreed upon an initial transfer rate of 1,000 metric tons an hour and a maximum transfer rate of 6,000 metric tons an hour. There should be no alterations to this caused by weather conditions or technical issues. So with the pumping capacity around 5,000 metric tons per hour, I expect the cargo transfer, including crude oil washing, will take about 30 hours, beginning at 17:30 hours.
Correct. And I have already got the details about the Mary's cargo of 85,000 metric tons of Gullfaks crude from the external cargo surveyors. They must also have the details regarding our present cargo ready soon.
Regarding the communication, I suggest we maintain the intership communication on the VHF channel 13 and also have as much visual contact as possible during the cargo transfer, if that's okay with you.
Sure, that's the safest way to do it. Now, after this meeting, I will make the last checks of the cargo transfer arrangements and give you a final confirmation of our readiness before the transfer is started.
Last issue is the disconnection. When the cargo is completed, I want the hoses to remain connected on the Rio, as we are also bringing in the next vessel alongside you. So we drain the hoses thoroughly and put the blanks on them, and then we range them in front of your manifold. Also the fenders, we leave them with you until the next berthing. Before we start unmooring, we shift the fender moorings from the Mary to the Rio.
That's understood.
Okay, the crew should be finished with the connection of hoses by now, so it will just take about 15 minutes before we are back and ready on the Mary. Just remember that before the cargo transfer commences, both the ISGOT ship shore safety checklist and the STS checklist number 4 should be filled in and agreed upon. I'll send the list for the Mary as soon as we are on board again and ready. But regarding communication, there is still one last task to do. Nick, maybe you can help us with that before we break up. Yes, the person in overall advisory control is responsible for reporting to the local authorities about commencement and completion of the operation. He also informs the organizers. Both masters inform their respective agents and keep the agent updated on all important timings, such as commencement of the operation, cargo transfer, completion time, delays, etc. The agent continuously keeps the ship owners, operators, and organizers updated. Okay, Nick, so far so good. The run-in and mooring went well, and now the cargo transfer just started. This phase of the STS operation is normally routine work. Both chief officers will be in close contact during this phase. On the Mary, it is hectic in the cargo control room, CCR. Starting pumps, an inert gas system, ordering of valves to be opened, and have watchmen stand by for any unforeseen events. As soon as the chief officer on the Rio is happy with the flow and everything is working the way it should, he orders to increase rate up to full rate. The deck duty officer must keep a time log. Later it will be entered into the deck logbook, and it also forms the basis for the timesheet, which is to be enclosed with the cargo documents. The important timed stages, like commenced cargo pumping, receiving, any intermediate starts and stops, commenced crude oil washing, finished crude oil washing, cargo transfer completed, must be agreed between the chief officers of the two ships. The timesheet forms the basis for calculating the expenses and who should pay what for the vessel's port call, i.e. the division between the charterers and ship owners. The respective agents for the two ships must be updated by the master, and the agent keeps the owners, operators, charterers informed. During the cargo transfer, we will keep an eye on the operation from the bridge here on the Mary, and furthermore, we must make rounds from time to time to check the moorings, fenders and hoses. Let's go for a round now. The crude oil washing was completed 2 hours ago. Right now they are draining the last hose. You can see how cautiously the crew disconnects it to ensure that it is free of liquid and pressure, and blank both the hose and the manifold flanges to avoid oil spillage. I think we can inform the authorities of the completion of the cargo transfer and give them the anticipated time of unmooring. John, we should be ready for unmooring and departure tomorrow around 6 a.m. Let's meet for a briefing here at 5:30 a.m.
No problem. Sleep well, both of you.
Thanks. I will just inform Michael on the Rio as well, and then we are off to bed.